We have trips for every section of our countries, so that our students will understand what's going on in our country in every part, and then try to understand what they are trying to do in each of their own Jangwat province. After that, we try to integrate all ideas and present it as a national policies to the government at the end of the student year.
You say students, but they're quite senior officers, aren't they?
Yes, yes. We use a different word in Thai. We call them Nakshiksa instead of Nakrien, but it's still a student.
How many came here to Phuket?
235 this class of 2551.
And they're full-time students, as you say, for how long?
Not actually, it's a full-time, but not a full day, because it's only a half day. Only when they have a trip in the country of or out of the country, that they do a full-time.
So you've had a presentation here by the Royal Thai Navy 3rd Naval Command, Area Command. What do you think about the presentation, and also how the participants can use this information for your future country's development?
Well, as I said, that we try to understand the problems in every part of our country, not just the military ones. We also understand and try to listen to the problems of each provinces, and also from the civilian sector. And after that, we try to combine them and put it, you know, like the national security.
But in particular here in Phuket and the Andaman, and the Navy's responsibility.
This morning, we listened to the problems of Phuket, like the need to train, you know, so that the logistic, so that they can carry the trade between Phuket and Phanga, Krabi, Surat. And also they talk about the problem with the water, you know, drinking water, and also the environment.
What about the Navy then, the operations here for the Navy? They cover a wide area,
yes,
not just along the coast, but out at sea.
Yeah.
What do you think some of the main problems or concerns are?
Well, like the Navy in other part of our country, they need more budget, they need more boats or ships, and also they need more personnel. Because the area of responsibility is so large. When you're talking about 30,000 square miles, that's a lot.
And it covers international waters as well, including neighboring countries with several other problems.
Yes.
Burma.
Well, they try to do a preventive diplomacy. They try to have a closer ties with our neighboring countries.
What do you think the most important function of the Navy is, for example, in, say, combating piracy, smuggling,
or the
refugee boat problem?
Yes, that's what they told us. They have three different areas, and they emphasize each with different responsibility. The first one, they emphasize the smuggling, the Rohingya, and the second one around Phuket area, the rescue, and the third one down south, they try to prevent illegal immigrants that try to do some problem with our southern provinces.
So what part does the National Defense College play in the future development of the country for say naval operations, but also for national reconciliation? I mean, a lot of problems in the country in the moment with the political process.
If you are talking about national reconciliation, you can see that we are having wearing the white shirt for 2 years now before anybody else. And the first one is that to try to understand each other, you have to listen first. You have to listen and then you try to understand what the other thing, and then after that you'll know the way to communicate. Let's say that the first thing is try to communicate. That's the first part, and that's one of our that's what our school do. You know, we come from different background, different sector of our countries, and each is also a high-ranking officers or the president of the company or whatever. But when they come here, they have to do away with all that and listen to the others, even though you don't think it's right. But first you have to listen, and then you try to understand why they think like that, you know.
So you're including listening to the